Big news in the neighborhood. This is our solar system. And a couple of years ago, almost everybody would have told you that orbiting our sun, you would find 9 planets. But as of this past year, we've got a 10th. Or do we?
This will absolutely rewrite the history of astronomy textbooks. There's now a 10th planet out there.
When Mike Brown and his team at Caltech announced they'd discovered what looked like a new planet, they did not give it a name. Names are bestowed by an international commission of scientists, so in the meantime, since they were looking at this little bright light for more than a year, they gave it a nickname.
It had no name at all, so we had to call it something, so when we talk to each other, we know what we were talking about. And so we always give things code names, nicknames, and this one we codenamed Xena.
From?
From, of course, the TV show Xena, Warrior Princess. Of course, Xena has a satellite, which we had no choice but to call Gabrielle, which is Xena's sidekick in the TV show.
No choice.
No choice.
But in proper scientific circles, when scientists talk about this object, they use
the very unwieldy 2003 UB313.
And it will stay 2003 UB313 until the International Astronomical Union officially decides that this is indeed a planet, which, by the way, they have not done. They're not even close.
We're in committee limbo, international committee limbo, which is about the worst possible place you could imagine being.
But what exactly is the problem? It looks like a planet. I mean, it's round. Planets are round.
Nothing's really round. The Earth has got a bulge in it, and Saturn is actually quite squashed.
Okay, but Xena's round enough, and it's got a moon, which is very planet-like, and it orbits the sun. But it turns out this matter is still debatable because there's no precise scientific definition for planet. And there hasn't been one for a long time.
Did you know that in 1801, a new planet was discovered orbiting between Mars and Jupiter?
Neil deGrasse Tyson is director of New York's Hayden Planetarium.
They called it Ceres, and then they looked some more, they found another planet, and another, and another. The count of planets in the early 1800s was greater than it is today. 13 planets in the solar system. And they kept looking, and the numbers kept growing, and they were running out of names. And they realized, rather than counting new planets, they had discovered a new swath of real estate in the solar system called the asteroid belt.
So Ceres became an unplanet and was redesignated to a new class, and it became the biggest asteroid.
So we've been there before. We know how to demote something.
And that's exactly what he did to Pluto. When the Hayden Planetarium reopened in 2000, Neil Tyson decided to de-planetize Pluto. In our opinion, he said, Pluto is now an icy object that's different from the other planets.
It's got enough ice so that if you were to take Pluto and transport it to where Earth is right now, the heat from the sun would evaporate the ice and it would grow a tail. And that's just no kind of behavior for a planet. We have words for things with tails. They're called comets.
Same for Xena, another icy body that lives in the Kuiper Belt out beyond Neptune. But a lot of people simply ignored Neil Tyson and the Hayden Planetarium and stuck with the list they'd learned in school. Remember those planets in the right order: Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, and Pluto.
My very educated mother just served us 9 pizzas.
Martha visits every Monday, must be, for Mars, and just stays until noon, period. So there are two stupid things there. There's an and, which is dumb, except the and is right where the asteroid belt is, and I don't know if that's an accident or not. And then I remember at the time, being in third grade, thinking that there's something funny about Pluto, if it really is just a period at the end of the sentence.
Sophisticated scientists and ordinary folks can't seem to get together on this one, and Mike Brown, even though he discovered what could be the 10th planet, has this advice for the scientists.
What I favor is the give-up approach, which is to say, the word planet is not scientific, and it doesn't need to be. And as astronomers, we just need to get over it.
These are the Pluto files, okay? This is hate mail that I've gotten from elementary school children, handwritten letters saying, please, Dr. Tyson, what are you doing with Pluto? What? That's our favorite planet. You are missing planet Pluto. Please make a model of it. This is what it looks like. It is a planet. Turn to the other page. A picture of Pluto. Dear Dr. Tyson, I think that Pluto is a planet for a lot of reasons, but you treat it like nothing. So if you can please leave it a planet, and if you don't, then I say it is. And have a good day.